So when we confront a divergent stream of energy, we don't focus on how it's manifested in our realm. We focus on the light within it. For that divergent stream, that energy, whether it's oppression or fear or anger or greed, well, where does it draw its sustenance from? Where does it draw its existence from? It draws its existence because it is reverberating in our reality the light of all source. Well, you see, how could someone who's doing such terrible things, oppressing others and being greedy and causing suffering, how could they reverberate the light of all source? And I say to you, they do. They just reverberate that frequency from the perspective of without. For when you witness their greed and when you witness their torture and their suffering and their oppression, when you witness it, you see the glory of all source, of divine love, of unconditional love. Because when you witness their greed, you witness exactly what the higher light is not. So they play a very pivotal role in giving you the coordinates of all source on the highest frequency. Now, if you want to vanquish that obtrusive energy, that energy of greed and ego, if you want to vanquish it from your world, if you want it to be free and coalesce with the love of all, then what you do is you don't witness it with your angelic intention and witness it as it manifests before you as something separate from you. You find its resonance within all within, within your heart, within your empathy, within your empathic portal, within your compassion, and you see its struggle, and you see how they are enslaved. They're enslaved to cycles, to modes of oppression and anger and greed, and all they really have is an infinite appetite to possess. And that infinite appetite to possess comes because they are trying to fill their infinite appetite of spirit with material variables. They're trying to fill their infinite appetite with material fascinations, and these do not work, for material is finite and the spirit yearns infinity. So how do you free that individual? You do it by recognizing the infinity in source that is driving them, that's giving them their energy. And you crystallize in your vision how this individual could manifest such beauty if they would merely come into balanced alignment. And then through the collective perception of this individual, giving them the power of recognition for what they potentially can be, they begin to wake up to the song of who they are. They begin to dance to the music of their higher self. They begin to actualize before your eyes and change their path.